us.
Learning about letters. Oh, hi. I'm glad you're here.
And I'm glad you're here, too. And I'm glad that I'm here, because today we're going to get to go through the whole alphabet. Right, Bird?
Right, Snuffy. And we're even going to read some words.
Words, Bird? Aren't I too little to be reading words?
Too little? You're 4.5 years old. And after we're finished looking at all the letters, we're going to listen to Luis read us a story.
A story, Bird? Oh, boy. I can hardly wait to get started. Which letter is first?
Well, they usually go in a certain order, you know, Snuffy. You know. Remember? A, B, C. D?
Oh, yes, Bert. Now I remember.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G. H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P.
Sure.
Q, R, S.
Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. Now I've sung my ABCs. Next time, won't you sing with me?
One more time!
Wonderful alphabet, and so useful, too. Now I know which letter comes first.
That's right, you do. And here it is.
The letter A.
Good reading, Snuff.
Thanks, Bird. Well, I better be moving along.
But where are you going?
To find some things that start with the letter A, Bird. See you soon.
Okay, Snuffy. There goes one great Snuffleupagus.
Hey, Big Bird.
That's Telly.
Oh. Oh, boy, are we in trouble.
Telly?
Huh?
What's wrong?
What's wrong? We have a whole entire alphabet to get through, and you ask what's wrong? Listen, you got to pay attention. We don't have time to mess around here. Now show them the letter, Bird. This is the letter A. Yeah, the letter A as in apple. Yeah, apple and airplane. Ooh. We made it through the letter A. Now, that brings us to the letter B. Yeah, there, see the B, letter B down there? B as in banana. Yeah. And look down there further. That's a box. And when I pull this string here, balloons. Yeah, and now we go over to the letter C. C as in...
Brr.
Cow.
Brr.
Now, what starts with the letter C? Cookie starts with C. Let's think of other things that start with C. Who cares about the other things? C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. Oh, cookie, cookie, cookie starts with C. Oh, C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. Oh, cookie, cookie, cookie starts with C. Hey, you know what? A round cookie with one bite out of it looks like a C. A round donut with one bite out of it also looks like a C. But it is not as good as a cookie. Oh, the moon sometimes looks like a C, but you can't eat that. So, C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. Yeah, C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. Oh, cookie, cookie, cookie starts with C. Yeah, cookie, cookie, cookie starts with C. Oh boy, cookie, cookie, cookie starts with C.
D, as in dentist.
Well, mind if I say a few words about flossing? Huh?
Some other time. Some other time.
All right.
Thanks.
What do you want?
I'm not here to see you, Oscar.
Oh, good. What?
I'm here to see Fluffy and Sophie and Blitzen and Schopenhauer.
Well, why didn't you say so in the first place?
Hey, back to Durham's Four. Someone to see you.
E. As in elephants.
My name is Francis Ferry. I'm from the land of Thorpe. Everyone there loves the letter F, because the letter F is fun. The letter F can go fast. And it can be fat. It can be furry. Or it can be flat. Or it can have flowers. Feathers. Or even fruit. Or an F can fade away. And so can a fairy. Farewell.
Yeah.
Frankfurters.
Fur.
Feathers.
G. Gallop.
G. Gorilla. Gorilla.
Is that me?
H. Horse.
Harry the horse had very long hair. It tripped him whenever he walked. It covered his eyes, tickled his nose, and got in his mouth when he talked.
I can possibly talk for all the fair of myself.
Huh. Horse.
I. Irvine.
I. Ice cream.
I. Icky.
I'm giving you a hint on this one. J. Jump. Go.
Key.
Close the house, Leonard!
K.
Hey, Bert.
Oh, hi, Ernie. Hey, I've been sitting here trying to think of what we could do with this here letter L.
Oh, well, let's see. You know, one thing, you could sing sort of a la-la-la song with the letter L.
What do you mean?
Well, there are all kinds of pretty words that begin with L. You know, you could sing a few la-la-las and some pretty little words, and you'd have a nice little song, you know?
La-la-la, like that?
Sure, go ahead. Try it.
Okay, let's see. La-la-la-la, lemon. La-la-la-la, light bulb.
Uh-huh.
La 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 la, lamppost. This is fun. La 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 la, lump in my oatmeal.
Well, that's not quite what I was thinking about, Bert.
No?
I mean, there are a lot of pretty L words, and I was sort of thinking of the ones that are more belting and lovely. You know, like la 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 la, laughter.
Oh, yeah, I see.
La 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 la, lullaby.
Like that, huh?
La 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 la, lollipop. La 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 la, lights in the sky.
Oh, Ernie, I got a great L word. This is a beauty. Oh, listen to this. La la la, linoleum.
No, Bert, listen to me. 'Cause L is such a lovely letter for words like licorice and lace. The letter L lights up your face, so why not la 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 la
la la la la, la
with me?
L, see, that's the letter L, and it's in the word closed. See? I'm showing the little honker that you can find letters almost everywhere. Oh, you want more? Okay, we'll go find some more letters. Come on, little honker.
A. B. C.
Let me draw a letter. You can just sit right there in your chair and draw a letter with your finger right in the air, okay? Here's how you're going to do it. We're going to start off and we're going to draw a line. We're going to draw a line that goes from here, a straight up and downy kind of a line right down to there. And we're going to go right there when I tell you to, okay? You want to do that with me? Okay. Everybody take your pointy finger and point it in the air, and here we go. On your mark, get set, go. Look at that. That's a beautiful line. Did you know you did that? Okay. Now we're going to draw another line just like that right over here, and we're going to draw it from here right down to there. Again, like that, just like that when I tell you to. Ready? Okay, here we go. Funny mark, get set, go! Beautiful. And here I am, Kermit the Frog, in between the two lines. But that is not a complete letter yet. We now have to draw another line from here right down about into here somewhere. Want to do that? When I tell you to, we're going to go like that. Ready? Take your fingers in the air and point them right up here. And here we go. On your mark, get set, go. Beautiful. Look at that. But now these two parts of the letter are not touching each other. And now we must make them touch. And so we have one more line to draw. And we're going to start up here at the top. And we're going to draw it right down to right this point right there. Okay? On your mark, get set, go. Beautiful. See that? And now the letter is all finished.
Hey, Froggy.
What?
What is that?
This, Grover, is the letter M. Right.
Hey, Cookie Monster. What letter is that that goes up, down, up, down?
That the letter M, Harry. And the letter M reminds me of a lot of wonderful things to eat.
Let's think of some.
Okay. Marshmallows.
Meatballs.
Ready to munch.
Malted milk.
Mustard.
Monster wants lunch.
Macaroni and melon.
Magnificent meal.
Oh, yeah. If Monster had food, now how yummy his tummy would feel. Oh, getting hungry.
Monster want marshmallows, meatballs, milk, melon.
But we got none of them.
So, monsters who are so hungry. We'll just eat this big letter M.
M. Nest. M. Nap.
Show you some magic stuff.
Okay. Rabbit.
Rabbit. Keep it coming.
Rocking. Rock.
Not bad, huh?
Radio. Rope.
Anything beginning with R.
Rat.
Keep it coming. Keep it coming.
Rip. Rain.
You better get under this umbrella, kid.
Okay, I'm ready. Rain!
You're wet!
We are doing great! S is for spaghetti and socks. Yeah, and T. T is right over here. And T is for toothbrush and telly. Now I'm going to tell you something about the letter U.
Never mind. I'll talk about myself. I'm useful, upbeat, unusual, and unbeatable. I'm up front in great words like up, umbrella, and underwear.
V. This is a vase that I'll put in this vat away from the villain in the Panama hat.
I am the villain in the Panama hat, and I'm after that vase that's here in his vat. I'll fill it with vinegar and throw in some varnish, and top that all off with some violets garnish. And now I will slip it here under my vest.
Oh, no, you don't, villain. You're under arrest. V.
Only four more letters to go, guys.
That's right.
All right, here we go. Double.
Waffle.
X.
X-ray.
Y.
Yo-yo.
And Z. Z.
Oh, I feel ridiculous.
Come on, Buster, Z. All right, I want to do this one. Z. Zebra.
Yay!
We can start.
Luis?
Hmm.
There aren't any pictures. How do you know what the story is?
Well, you see all these words right there?
Uh-huh.
Well, those are the words that tell the story, see? Huh. And I'm going to read them to you.
Well, I know some of these letters.
You do?
Yeah, there's a T and an H. And...
Uh-huh. Well, see, in this story, there's a lot of words that begin with the letter P. Huh. And do you know the sound of the letter P? Yeah? A lot of words begin with the letter P. Like, well, there's peanut, there's pony, pumpkin. Okay? Now, in this story, I want you to listen for the words that begin with the letter P. And this story is called The King Banishes the Letter P. You ready?
Uh-huh.
Okay, here we go. Once upon a time, there lived a king named Peter the Persnickety, who was very fond of the letter P. Now, one day, he was walking in the royal garden with his daughter, the Princess Penelope.
Oh, look at how pretty. Look at all the peonies and poppies and petunias.
Say nothing of the peas and the pumpkins and the potatoes.
When suddenly...
Oh! Biddle, I've been pelted by a ping-pong ball.
Pardon me, your powerfulness.
Then, as the king was getting over his surprise, he accidentally bumped into...
Oh! My pet porcupine!
Well, all of this upset the king so that he promptly proposed a proclamation.
Inasmuch as my royal highness has been pelted by a ping-pong ball and pricked by a pet porcupine, I hereby proclaim that from now on, Nothing that starts with the letter P will be allowed in my kingdom.
Anything you say, Your Highness, but excuse me there.
What?
Yeah, well, pen here and proclamation will have to go. They begin with P, you know.
Oh,
poor King Peter. And that wasn't all. That very night at dinner.
Oh, here you are, King, your favorite dinner. Peanut butter and pickle pizza.
No, sorry. Peanut butter, pickle, and pizza all begin with P. Huh. Have to go. Nope. Sorry,
monsieur.
Maybe this wasn't such a good idea after all. Oh, here comes my daughter, the Princess Penelope. I'll ask her.
Oh, Father.
Oh, no, sorry, King. You see, Princess starts with P, too, so we'll have to banish her. Come on, sweetie.
Poor me. I'm all alone in my palace.
No. You see, the palace begins with P. We'll have to take that, too.
So the citizens pulled the palace apart, and all of this made King Peter very, very sad. So he issued another announcement.
I tell you what, I hereby declare that from now on, this is a royal change of mind, that's what this is, okay? From now on, everything that begins with P is welcome in my kingdom.
And so they rebuilt the palace, and the people brought piles of presents.
Oh, Papa.
And from that day on, whatever started with the letter P had a place in the palace. And forever after, life in the kingdom of King Peter the Persnickety was positively peachy.
Hey!
You like that?
Thank you. That was a good story.
Oh, Snuffy, what's that you got there?
It's an apple, Bird. Apple starts with the letter A. Now we can go on to the next letter, Bird.
But Snuffy, we already went all the way through the alphabet.
You mean I missed the whole alphabet and the words too and even Louise's story?
Yeah, well, Snuffy. Aw, come on now, please don't cry. Look, I got a great idea. We'll do everything all over again.
Oh, that would be wonderful, Bird.
Okay, just let me catch Telly before he leaves. Hey, Telly! Oh, Telly!
Oh, Bird always has the most brilliant ideas.
You mean you want me to go through the whole entire thing all over again?
Well, yeah, it's for Snuffy, you know. Huh? I mean, we'll all help like we did the last time.
Yeah, sure.
So, you don't mind, do you, Telly?
Well, of course not. All right, you people, we've got a lot of stuff to get organized here.
Oh, yes, and maybe this time I can say a few words about flossing.
Yeah, right. Okay, hand that O up here. Let me go up there. Okay, all right, we got this here.
Well, in case you haven't noticed, Sesame Street was brought to you today by the letters A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. The alphabet game.
And now it's time for everybody's favorite game show,
Alphabet Treasure Hunt!
And here is your Alphabet Treasure Hunt host, Sonny Friendly!
Yeah, hey, and welcome. Welcome to Alphabet Treasure Hunt, where the letter A always stands for applause. Yeah. Yes, and now let's all meet today's contestants.
From Muddy Falls, Montana, please welcome Gary Grouch.
Hi there, Gary. How you doing?
Rotten, Sonny. But I'm looking forward to winning my way, which is to say, losing.
Wonderful, wonderful. Now let's meet our next contestant.
From the Puppydale Puppy Farm, let's give a big hand to Dimples the dog.
Hi there, Dimples. How you doing? Well, that's all the time we have to chat. Let's meet our last contestant.
From Sesame Street, let's say hello to Big Bird.
Hi there, Big. How you doing?
Just great, Sonny. And I'm real excited because all my friends are watching me. Hi, Snuffy. Hi, Telly. Hi.
Well, that's all the time we have for hello, because it's time to play
Alphabet Treasure Hunt.
Yes, and this is how the game goes. The alphabet will flash on our magic game board. And whenever it stops on a letter, you will have just 30 seconds to find something that starts with that letter. If you do, you will get a slice of cookie. Marvelous. And the first one to get 3 slices and fill in the whole cookie will be our winner. Now, to tell us about the letters we'll be using, here's my best and dearest green pal, Kermit the Frog. Take it away, Kerm baby.
A is for alligator, B is for bayou, C is for cypress trees, D is the dew. E is for everything like F, ferns or G, grass, that's H, home to you. I is for insects, J for juniper, K, kelp, L, log, M is the moon. N is noontime, O is for otter, P for possum, he'll be sleeping soon. Q is quicksand, that's very tricky. R, rushes, S, snakes, T, tar that gets you sticky. U is the universe, that's V, vast and W wide. X marks the spot where I love to hide. Y is the yellow bird that sings so sweet, which brings me back to Z, and now my alphabet's complete in the swamp. A, alligator, B, bayou, C, cypress trees, D, dew, E for everything like F, ferns, G, grass, H, home to you. I, insects, J, juniper, K, kelp, L, log, M is the moon, N, noontime, O for otter, P, the possum who'll be sleeping soon. Q is quicksand, that's very tricky, remember? R, rushes, S, snakes, T, tar that gets you sticky. U is the universe, that's V, vast and W wide. X marks the spot where I love to hide. Y is the yellow bird that sings so sweet, which brings me back to Z, and now my alphabet's complete in the swamp. Woo-hoo. Ribbit, ribbit. Woo-hoo. Ribbit, ribbit.
Thank you, Kerm. And now, here's the moment you've been waiting for. Let's turn to our magic letter board and see what our first treasure hunt letter is going to be.
A! B!
And it's the letter B! Contestants, you have 30 seconds to find and bring back something that begins with a letter B, starting now!
Ha!
Wait, Dimples. Wait a minute, Dimples. Don't roll onto me. We gotta hurry. I gotta go bring back something to be into the bee. Dimples.
Can they do it, audience? Remember, they have only 30 seconds.
Dimples, stop that. Let go. Dimples.
Oh. Just in time, there goes our 30-second buzzer.
Hey, well, don't get your hopes up. I just brought this trash can in here because I thought the place could use a little decoration, you know? And for your information, trash can starts with a letter T, not B.
Well, you're right, Gary, but, Yes, that trash can is full of bugs, and the word bugs begins with B. So, Gary Grouch, you want a piece of the cookie?
No, I don't want it. Take it away.
Oh, wonderful, Gary. Now, let's see what our other contestants have brought back. Dimples the dog, what a clever dog you are. You brought back Big Bird, and Big Bird starts with the letter B, so you want a piece of the cookie!
No, wait. But he didn't bring me back. He didn't do anything. He only stopped me from getting anything.
Oh, Big Bird, I'm sorry. That makes you the only one who didn't bring back something beginning with B. Well, better luck next time.
But the dog was holding me.
Isn't that wonderful, audience? Hear that? The magic board is going crazy, which can only mean, yes, it's bonus letter time. Everybody's a winner on Alphabet Treasure Hunt.
He was holding on to my leg.
And our first bonus letter of the day is...
The dog.
The letter D.
D, 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 doggy. D, D, dangerous dragon. D, 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 donkey, ducky, dinosaur. O, D, 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 delicious. D, 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 don't drop dishes. Dig some dirt, dunk a donut for dessert, draw a daisy that's delightful to see when D is handy, it's fine and dandy. D, 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 D is such a very nice letter, each day I like it better, that lovely letter called D. You know, there are all kinds of words that begin with the letter D. There's doctor and dentist and dime, dollar, daddy, door, dandelion, and draw a daisy that's D, delightful to see when D is handy. It's fine and dandy, D, 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 D is such a very nice letter. Each day I like it better. That lovely letter called D, 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 having fun, but now I'm D, 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 done.
Yes, delightful indeed. And here we are back with our delightful contestants, ready for another try at our magic letter board. And what will be our next treasure hunt letter? And our contestants are off again.
What now?
You stay. You're good. Don't follow me this time. You be good. Stay.
Will they do it this time? Will they find something that starts with the letter F?
Yeah! Whoa! Ah, my tail! Ah, Dimples, my tail! Listen, I can tell you something. Dimples didn't bring back anything this time because Bird does not start with the letter F.
No, But Feather does. And I see a couple of big yellow ones right there.
Yes, because he bit my tail. Those are my feathers.
Well, they may be. But Dimples brought them back. So, Dimples, you get another piece of the cookie.
Well, gee.
And now there's only a couple of seconds left. And yeah, Gary's back. And what is it, Gary, that you brought back?
Well, this is just my lunch. And lunch does not start with the letter F. And it's also wrapped up in this cruddy old newspaper, which likewise does not also.
Yes. But if my nose does not deceive me, your lunch is a rather pungent fish. And fish does begin with the letter F. Oh, no. Yes, Gary Grouch of Muddy Falls, Montana, you've earned another piece of the cookie.
I don't want another piece of the cookie. Hey, if you take it back, I'll give you my fish.
Isn't he wonderful? Wonderful. Well, Big Bird, I'm sorry, but you seem to have struck out again. But don't be discouraged, because there's still a ghost of a chance that you can catch up.
Hey, listen, this dog hasn't brought back anything here. He's just running around being a dog. And that Grouch doesn't even want to win.
You hear that? You know what that means. Are we lucky today or what? It looks like our magic board is lighting up again, which means it's bonus letter time.
Look at my tail.
And yes, it's a double bonus. H and J.
It's almost ready. My greatest invention. With only three simple working parts. This straight piece here, and another straight piece here, and this cross piece between them. All right, everything is ready. My great masterpiece is about to be invented. Stand back. I'm drawing the switch. It works. It works. My new invention works. But wait. It has to have a name. I know. I will call it capital H. Yes, capital H. And I will use the H in words. Oh, how perfect. Now, let me see. Since the H is heavy, I use it to start the word heavy. And of course, the H is very handsome, so I'll use it as the first letter in the word handsome. Oh, what a great invention, this H. Oh, it's absolutely perfect, as useful as controlled capital letter H. Well, maybe it could use a smidge more work. Come home, H, come home.
Jay. I was named after the letter J because everything my family does starts with a J.
There are folks who poke fun at the way my family's run. It's a joking, joyful, jumping jamboree. So if you'd like a job, just join our jolly mob and we'll show you how much fun a J can be. My sister's into judo. My father likes to jog. My mother washes jelly jars. My uncle jumps a log. Big brother flies a jet plane. My nephew drives a Jeep. Junior is a jitterbug. And grandma juggles sheep. My niece plays in a jazz band. My granddad Jimmy's doors. My cousin runs a jackal farm. My auntie judges boards. Great uncle raises John Quills. Great granddad plays with jacks. My wife became a journeyman. And me, well, I just stay out of their way. Jay.
All right, looking at the cookies again tells me that Big Bird is still behind. Dimples the dog, on the other hand, is doing very well. In fact, he's still tied for first place with Gary Grouch. So, let's see what our magic board has in store for us next.
A-B-C-D-E-F-G-H-I-J-K-L-M-N-O.
right now, Dimples, don't you fall on me this time. You be good.
Oh, joy.
Stay. Stay.
And the time is ticking away, those few precious seconds, folks. Will they make it back in time? I can hardly stand the excitement. But I may not have to, because I think I hear someone coming back already.
I'm back, and look what I got.
I'm sorry, Big Bird, but you brought back a bunny, and bunny does not start with the letter R.
It's a rabbit, a rabbit.
But look at Dimples here.
He's not doing anything.
That's right. He's resting, and resting begins with the letter R.
He's not resting. He's being a dog. That's what dogs do. They lie around like that. Off down.
I'm a rabbit.
I know that. Tell him.
Oh, I'm sorry. Time's up.
Hey, Sonny.
Gary Grouch, what are you doing up there?
I'm cutting a hole in your ceiling.
Wonderful, wonderful. Why?
Because you keep giving me pieces of the cookie, and I'm angry. And for your information, hole begins with H, not R.
Well, will you look at this, folks? Gary Grouch cut a hole in the ceiling to let in the rain. Yes, Gary Grouch, rain does start with the letter R, and you've just earned your third piece of the cookie. Hey, never a dull moment on the alphabet treasure hunt. Oh, it looks like you're in for a treat, folks, because that's the magic board saying it's bonus letter time yet again. And this time it's a triple bonus, Q, S, and W.
Hey, can I do that again?
Now the letter is Q, and one word that begins with Q is question. Now here is a question for you. Remember, the answer will start with a Q.
What's a Q?
Oh, hi, Grover.
Hi.
Q is the letter of the alphabet that looks like an O with a little tail at the bottom.
Oh, now I remember. You can start the song again.
Thanks, Grover.
You're welcome.
Now here is a question for you. Remember, the answer will start with a Q. Just think of a duck, be it white, brown, or black. What sound does it make? Why, a ducky goes...
No,
Grover, a ducky goes quack. Quack is a Q word, the answer is quack.
Okay.
Look, Grover, try this one. Now here is a question for you. Remember, the answer will start with a Q. In stores you buy milk in containers of sorts. But what do you call them? You call these things...
Cows!
No, that's not right. The answer is quartz. Quartz is a Q word. The answer is quartz. Now, what made you think of cows?
I don't know. I think I heard one go moo a minute ago.
Grover?
Hmm?
Forget about the cows.
Okay.
Now here is a question for you. And once more the answer begins with a Q. Remember a king in a story you've seen. To whom was he married? He's wed to a...
farmer!
No, the answer is queen. Queen is a Q word. The answer is queen.
Gee, I thought it was a farmer.
What farmer?
The one who brought the cow in here.
Grover, I've had quite enough. I quit.
Okay, come on, cow. Let's go home.
Something about the letter S. Oh, I'm Sammy the Snake, and And I look like the letter S. Oh, yes. I'm all wiggly and curvy. I look like the letter S, I confess. But do you know the sound? Sammy the snake. Well, the sound of the letter S is the sound I make. I say, let me tell you about it, out of sight. I say, in the morning, in the afternoon. Yes, I do, to all my snake friends. I say, see you later, Slinky. She's my sister. I say, see you soon. Yeah, she's super slick. Yeah, I'm Sammy the Snake. And I have to confess that I look and I sound just like the letter S. Now, come on, all you children, and make that S sound with me. Here we go. Yeah, that's fine. That's the sound you hear at the beginning of a word like sing or story time. Let's do it again. Yeah, you hear that sound at the beginning of a word like seesaw, silly, or super, star, seven. Yeah, I'm Sammy the Snake, and I have to confess that I look and I sound just like the letter S.
This weird story of Wanda the Witch is brought to you courtesy of the letter W.
Wanda the Witch lived somewhere west of Washington. Around her waist, instead of a belt, she wore a worm. Wanda had a pet weasel.
I'm a weasel.
And on her head, a wiry wig. On Wednesday, in the middle of winter, Wanda walked to the well to get water to wash her wig. But the wheel on the well was worn, and Wanda grew weary. So she waved her wand, and her washtub filled with warm water. But just as Wanda was about to drop her wig into the warm water, a wild wind whipped the wig from her hand and blew it away forever. Which taught Wanda this lesson. Witches who wash their wigs on windy winter Wednesdays are wacky.
This witch story was brought to you courtesy of the letter W.
And now, folks, before we tabulate the scores and announce this week's winner, let me remind you of those 26 fabulous letters without which there'd be no alphabet treasure hunt. Between Gary Grouch and Dimples the Dog. Hey, do things get exciting here on Alphabet Treasure Hunt or what?
Hey, the dog didn't do anything, and I found a rabbit.
Oh, buddy.
Oh, my
Now, Dimples and Gary, to break the tie, I'm going to ask you one question. And whoever gives me the correct answer first will be our winner. I'll give you a hint. The correct answer begins with R. Ready?
Hey, how can he answer questions? He's just a dog.
All right. Here's the question. What is the top part of a house called? Gary?
Who cares?
Sorry, that's not right. Okay, Dimples, what is the top of a house?
Roof!
Roof! That's right!
He barked. He didn't answer the question. He just barked.
Hey, is that a clever dog or what?
I mean, it just sounded like roof. I mean, if you asked him what was at the bottom of a tree and he barked, you'd think he said root.
Root!
And if you asked him who was the greatest outfielder the Yankees ever had, he would have said Ruth.
DiMaggio?
What do you know? You're just a bunny.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner and this week's champion of Alphabet Treasure Hunt, Dimples the Dog. That's right, Dimples. That is our grand prize winner. You will receive...
year's supply of doggy cookies, a matching set of rhinestone-studded flea collars, and last but not least, a trip for two to Club Pet in Cancun. That's right, Club Pet, the favorite getaway spot of the swinging pet set, where every night is a different luau.
And of course, Dimples, these wonderful prizes are for you to share with a friend of your choice. Now, would you care to tell us who that lucky friend is going to be?
Ruff.
Big Bird?
What?
Is that who you want to share your prizes with, Dimples?
Ruff.
And it looks like Big Bird from Sesame Street is the lucky bird who'll be chewing doggy cookies all the way to Club Pet in Cancun as he travels in style wearing his new rhinestone-studded flea collar.
Wow.
Dimples, you really want me to go with you?
And that's it for today. This is Sunny Friendly and...
Can I bring the rabbit?
...saying join us again for another fun-filled edition of...
Alphabet Treasure Hunt!
Yeah! Was this fun or what?
We'll be right back.